Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, here we will discuss about the next topic of feedback amplifier, that is chapter number 5. That topic is characteristics of negative feedback. So as far as negative feedback is concerned, there are lots of characteristics that are hazardous sometimes, and sometimes it will be very, very beneficial. So contradictory part is the gain. So gain is reduced by using the negative feedback, but at the same time I'm getting so many beneficial quantities, so many beneficial characteristics from the negative feedback that we have to learn in this particular video. As far as negative feedback is concerned, we all know that we are getting less gain, okay? So that is the first characteristics. Whether it is advantageous or disadvantageous, that doesn't matter for me right now for the characteristics of the negative feedback, okay? So we will write the reduction of the gain. Right? As far as reduction of the gain is concerned, sometimes you feel that why we are using that negative feedback then, right? At the same time, with the same gain factor, I will get that desensitivity of the gain. What is desensitivity of the gain is? Okay, so if I'm saying that gain factor sometimes gets varied, right? So even if it is linear amplifier, that gain factor, if the output voltage is fluctuating, then the gain factor may get vary, right? So that gain factor variation in the open loop gain leads to have very small change in the gain at the closed loop configuration. That is beneficial for us, right? So even if gain is reduced, that change in the gain is not that much higher as compared to your open loop gain. So change in the gain is not high, okay? That is called as desensitivity, okay? So desensitivity factor is important aspect as far as negative feedback is concerned, okay? So here we will say that desensitivity increases. That means whatever change in the output voltage I'm getting, change in the gain perspective I'm getting, that is not higher as compared to your open loop gain. Okay, so that we will discuss in detail about the effect of the gain on the effect of the negative feedback on the gain, right? So that is a different topic altogether. Here we will learn only the characteristics. Now the second characteristic that we will be getting is nothing but it controls the input and output resistance. So as far as amplification is concerned, we all know that your ideal voltage amplification ke liye, we have to have the input resistance should be very, very high and output resistance should be very, very low. Okay, so we'll take one simple example. First of all, we will write that it controls input and output resistance. Okay, so it controls the input and output resistance. Take one simple example. So let's have one different page for that. Let us understand. I will draw two diagrams that we have already learned. Okay, so as far as this, let's say CRC, RE, this is R2 and this is R1, and I'm saying that this is your DC reference voltage, this is your ground, and this is your input voltage I'm giving at the base terminal. I'm getting output at the collector terminal. Now as far as input output characteristics, input output resistances are concerned, so if we draw the AC equivalent circuit, that will look like simple. This will be RB, that is nothing but the parallel combination of R1 and R2, and here we'll be getting the RPi 1. And keep this in mind that what if I apply the capacitance which will be at the parallel to your RE. If I am placing parallel capacitance with RE, then I can say that RE will be redundant. That means that this particular resistance will not come into picture as far as AC equivalent model is considered. Now we will do the AC equivalent model for this particular circuit, and we'll be getting that this is your GM V pi 1, and question arises, if I apply capacitor in parallel with RE, right, then RE will not come into picture. That means there is no path for the output voltage to reach at the input, right, because current is passing but voltage is not passing, right. So I can say that this RE, if it comes into picture, if capacitor is not there, right, then what will be the effect on the input side resistance? Obviously this input resistance will get increased. So if we say that this RE will get shifted towards the base side, I will be getting this RB will become R pi 1 plus 1 plus beta times RE. So that factor, this particular factor, will lead to increase your input resistance, right? So this is how that RE is nothing but your feedback circuit, and that will lead to change your input resistance, right? So obviously your output resistance will also get increased, but not at that much significant level, right, in this particular circuit. But obviously in another circuit it is important to have the negative feedback to control your input as well as output resistance. Okay, so this example is enough, I guess, for the characteristics. Second characteristic, that is nothing but controls the input and output resistance. So let's move towards this third part of your characteristics of the negative feedback, and the third characteristic says that it increases the bandwidth. Practically, this is a very important aspect as far as amplifier is concerned. So if I'm increasing the bandwidth, I can use the large range of the frequencies to work as an amplifier, right? So this is beneficial characteristics as far as negative feedback amplifier is concerned. Then let's move towards the fourth characteristic. That fourth characteristic is immunity of noise. So the fourth characteristic that we have learned, immunity of the amplifier towards the noise, immune to noise. So I can say that if noise is reduced, then your distortion will also getting reduced. So I can say that your less distortion, or I can say that distortion is reduced by using negative feedback. Okay, so increased bandwidth is done, noise immunity is done, then less distortion is done, reduction of the gain is done. Now we'll have to learn the sixth characteristic as non-linearity. It will not affect the non-linearity. So as far as non-linearity is concerned, we will learn the complete task, complete mathematical expression regarding this non-linearity, bandwidth, then noise, then reduction with the gain, desensitivity. All these things we will learn as a separate chapter. Here we will just have to learn that these are nothing but the characteristics of negative feedback. So we will stop here for this particular video. In the next videos we will learn some different aspects of the negative feedback, some classification of the negative feedback topologies, and then we will learn some problem based on the negative feedback. So stay tuned for that. Learn more and more EDC along with me, along with Ekeeda videos. Thank you so much.